Welcome back to the Azure Enablement Show and our series on learning resources. I'm April Edwards, your host for the series. Now we'll continue our tour of resources ready to help you become a better Azure professional. So without further ado, let's head off to our first destination.
Coming up, we're going to Microsoft certifications.
Hello, my name is Sandra Marine, and I am part of the Microsoft Learning Organization. I am the go-to-market lead for Azure training and certifications.
When someone goes to Microsoft certifications for the first time, what will they find and how do they get started?
So you go to microsoft.com/certifications, and the first thing is to identify your business and career goals. And with that, you can get the associated role jobs and a specialization. This will allow you to find the right set of certifications for you or for your team. We have a variety of Microsoft certifications for Azure across fundamentals, role-based, and specialties. Some certifications are better for IT pros, some for developers, some for data and AI professionals, and some are actually good for different professions. So depending on your goals, you will have different options.
Why should developers seek out certifications?
We have certifications that are designed specifically for developers, and these certifications validate the skills developers need to innovate with best-in-class applications.
How should developers get started with certification?
The first certification that I recommend for developers is the obvious one, is Azure Developer Associate. So every developer that wants to prove their skills on Azure should go for that one. And from there, you can go, you have more alternatives to keep growing, like Azure IoT Developer Specialty or DevOps Engineer Expert.
Are there any non-obvious certifications that developers might want to pay attention to?
There is one certification that doesn't seem obvious for developers, but it's a perfect fit, and is the Azure AI Engineer certification. This certification lives in the intersection of apps and data and AI solutions, and is all about embedding the skills required to embed artificial intelligence capabilities into applications, cognitive services, natural language processing. So this is a very cool certification for developers that sometimes goes below the radar because of the name doesn't suggest developers.
Are there any things that developers might not know about Microsoft certifications?
There are two interesting things about certifications that are not necessarily well known. First, if you are preparing for any Microsoft certification, there is a document that must be your first step. It's called the Skills Outline document, and you will find it in every certification and exam pages. This document is key to understand what knowledge domains are covered in exams. So this is your guide to prepare. And the second thing is Microsoft official practice test. We have for almost every exam, we have a practice test, and they are a great trial run for the actual exam. All the objectives covering the exams are covered in the practice test. So you will find that this is a good resource to prepare.
Our next stop is Instructor Led Training.
Hi, my name is James Seymour. I manage the Azure Apps and Infrastructure Technical Content Team.
How do you get started with Instructor Led Training?
Well, to get started in Instructor Led Training, I think the best thing to do is to go look for your local learning partner. They can really help you set up a learning path. They can customize training for whatever your needs are. They give you personal attention, and we also keep the content up to date so you know that everything you're getting from them is the latest and greatest.
Why should developers go to instructor-led training?
Developers should go to instructor-led training because it gives them that personalized attention that they need. Because you might be focused on one particular area of development or just generally need to understand the broad ecosystem or platforms. An instructor-led training course can help you understand exactly what you need because it's led by people that have been developers. It's taught by experts that really understand what you need to know.
How should developers plan their instructor-led training?
I think the best way for a developer to jump into instructor-led training is to really figure out what it is that they need to know. Where are they in their learning journey? If you're new to development, it might be a good idea to start with fundamentals, which gives you a broad view of what the Azure platform is, and then go into the specific focus that you want, whether that's Azure developer or DevOps engineer or IoT developer, whatever that is. But really the place to start depends on where you are in your current learning journey.
Are there any tips for getting the most from instructor-led training?
The best tip I could give to a developer that's wanting to start is, again, figuring out where they are in their journey. If they're new, they should take fundamentals, which understand the broad ecosystem of Azure, or they can jump straight into whatever their particular focus is. If that's IoT or SAP or whatever it is in Azure, we have training that meets their needs.
What's one thing that most developers probably don't know about instructor-led training?
I would say the biggest thing that developers don't know about instructor-led training is really the scope of it. We have tons of tracks that really can often meet their needs, but even beyond that, there's tons of supplemental material on Microsoft Learn. So it's pretty common to have a course that's customized by a Microsoft certified trainer that not only teaches Azure Developer, but may also have several ancillary products or different technologies that can go hand in hand. That's really what you're looking for because that's what you use in your business. So then I would say, in addition to instructor-led training, Microsoft Learn can really help you round out those skills and give you a broad perspective.
Next, we visit Microsoft Docs.
Hi, my name is David Berry. I'm a program manager in Microsoft Docs for Azure Developer Experiences.
Hi, I'm Ornella Altunian. I'm a content developer for Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code.
What is Microsoft Docs and how do you get started with it?
So Microsoft Docs are a one-stop shop for all Microsoft products and services. And this content is built by the product managers and engineers and content developers who actually build the product. So you really can't get more official than that. And if you go to our page, you'll see a documentation section. And this will bring up a huge product directory of all of the things we offer. For example, if you want to look at Azure, then you'll be taken to all of the Azure products. And each one of these has its own table of contents with a lot of content. So there's reference content, tutorials, quick starts, all of these different types of ways that you can learn. And so for products that have multiple versions, so for example, if we go to something like Visual Studio here, you'll see that if you click on any content, in the upper left-hand corner, you'll get a version picker. And so you'll be able to see that same content for multiple versions of the product.
What are some tips and tricks for using Microsoft Docs?
Something that a lot of people don't know about is that you actually can download our docs as a PDF. And where you do that is down here in the lower left-hand corner with this download PDF link. This is something I've used before when I've had a flight that I'm getting on or I'm not going to have Wi-Fi access. If there's a technology that I want to brush up on, I'll download the entire doc set as a PDF onto my tablet, and then I'll have some reading material for those times that I don't have Wi-Fi or connectivity. Another thing that a lot of people don't know about our docs is that all of our docs are open source, meaning that if you, as a member of the community, see something that's wrong, like a spelling or a grammatical error, or maybe you read something and you feel like, you know, this could be explained a little bit more clearly, you can actually go in and you can actually make that change yourself. And the way you do that is by going up here to the edit button once you're signed in to docs. And that actually will take you to a page where you actually can edit the actual doc in Markdown right in the browser. You make your edits. Those will go to the content developer that's responsible for the page. They'll look over those edits. They'll, within a couple of days, approve those edits. And then those will actually be part of the live doc set. And so this is a great way that if you want to, you know, help out the rest of the community by improving the docs, you actually can do that very easily right in the browser.
How does Microsoft Docs help developers succeed?
So when I think about how does Docs help people succeed, if you look through our docs, through all of our quick starts on our tutorials, we have a lot of sample scenarios and a lot of sample code that are built in there. And those can get you experience actually building something with our products and our technologies. But they also can provide the basis for the things that you need to build yourself. You can take some of that sample code or some of those commands right out of the document and then use that to form your solution. And that really can speed up your success when using our products and using our docs.
Coming up, we visit GitHub.
Hi, everybody. My name's Dave Burneson. I'm a technical advocate with the GitHub and Azure DevOps team.
What is GitHub, and how should developers get started using it?
GitHub is the home for all of your DevOps tools. Everything from source control, security checks for your code, continuous integration and continuous deployment tools, and so much more. You can get started by going to the GitHub Learning Lab.
Why should developers go to GitHub?
Developers should go to GitHub because it is the home of open source for projects like Kubernetes, TensorFlow, GraphQL, et cetera. And there are over 56 million registered users on GitHub. So you can use the same tools and systems that the world is using for open source software today.
How should developers get started using GitHub?
A developer can get started right away by going to GitHub and GitHub Learning Lab and leverage the introductory learning paths and modules to learn how to use GitHub for source control and security and everything, and get started with all the DevOps tools they need.
Is there any GitHub content that developers might want to pay particular attention to?
There are some non-obvious sections in both Microsoft Learn and GitHub Learning Lab that will help developers get started. Sections such as learning how to use Markdown in issues and pull requests and everything to create rich content for your audience and everyone involved on your team.
What's one thing that many developers might not know about GitHub?
One thing that developers may not know about GitHub as a learning destination is the way in which GitHub has grown over the last couple of years to become much more than just source control and simple security, simple issue management. GitHub has grown to become a complete set of DevOps tools, including continuous integration, continuous delivery, discussions, and many other tools for all of your DevOps needs.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour across Azure Learning Resources. If you're looking to engage with any of the resources we visited in this video, please check the text in this video's description. Enjoy your learning and see you next time.